Thank you very much. Just a quick question. How is what is happening in the Eurozone and the policy prescriptions that are being put forward differ from what the United States did during the TARP situation back in 2008?
In some respects, there are similarities, but there are also important institutional differences, of course, between the U.S. and Europe. Important similarity is that this is a crisis of confidence and a crisis that has led to a huge increase in uncertainty with potentially very negative impact, if not contained. Both here in the U.S. and in Europe, what is needed, therefore, is an overwhelming, powerful response to reduce concerns, to reduce the uncertainty, to reassure investors that the situation is being contained. In Europe, it's been more difficult to put this decisive response in place because of institutional constraints. There are 17 members of the Eurozone, and they all need to reach agreement on steps to establish and develop these crisis resolution mechanisms. That has taken time. And politics is always complicated, but now we're talking about the politics in a multiplicity of countries. There's also a difference in the role of the European Central Bank, the ECB, from the role of the Fed. And during the ARC financial crisis, US Treasury and the Fed were able to work very closely together and very quickly to develop effective tools to reassure markets that funding would continue to be available. The ECB's legal constraints have meant that there could not be such close relationship between the ECB and European treasuries. And for this reason, the mechanisms that are being created now to reassure markets that funding will be available need to be more complicated and have taken more time to design.
In discussing those differences, one of the reasons that Europe seems to be having difficulty with this is because, unlike the United States, where we have a union of 50 sovereign states governed by a federal government, the individual nations of the EU seem to be having trouble, and I think very understandably so, with the concept of their taxpayers bailing out the investors for problems that were caused by other nations' lack of fiscal discipline. In the United States, that was clearly a much lower hurdle to get over for the federal government to do, rather than trying to corral 50 different state legislatures to agree to do that. But doesn't the central principle of what they're trying to do in the EU equate with what was done in the TARP? In short, whether it is by individual nations of the EU or done in the United States by the federal government, the way they're trying to solve this crisis of confidence is to essentially tell investors, to the greatest of their ability, that you will not lose money under any circumstance, and that the taxpayers will cover it if you run into this. Is that not the case?
That is certainly the case, and that's particularly relevant for the creation of this firewall that we have discussed. But I think the problems in Europe go well beyond the construction of the firewall. There also needs to be these fundamental economic reforms in a number of countries in Europe, and Greece being the most prominent example. A commitment to massive fiscal consolidation and to deep-rooted reforms that restore dynamism to the Greek economy. Ultimately, the European crisis cannot be resolved until countries around Europe are able to convince markets they are going to be able to achieve the fiscal adjustments and the economic reforms that restore sustainability.
And just, if I may, Mr. Chairman, just a quick point. That one of the problems that Greece experienced, much like it once did during the time of the Athenian city-state, was when people realized that they could avail themselves of the public treasury for their own benefit. And the absence of fiscal discipline that you see out of a country like Greece, where they have an exploding public sector and an anemic private sector, are not necessarily constrained to Europe. Thank you.